I'm Ilyan Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to look at MeshCentral support for YubiKey one-time passwords. MeshCentral supports lots of different two-factor authentication, and this is critical for security in MeshCentral. In fact, I recommend that anybody who has an account on any MeshCentral server, except unless they're really private on their local network, but anything that's on the internet, you should really require that your users have two-factor authentication, and you should, as a user, have two-factor authentication. That is because you're protecting a lot of accounts on MeshCentral, and you're doing it with, you know, if it's only a password, then somebody guessing that password correctly or that password being used by on another website that's been hacked or so on can open all these computers to being attacked, the computers that you manage in your account. So it's super, super critical that you have two-factor authentication. In this video, we're gonna look at an unusual two-factor authentication that is supported in MeshCentral, and that is the YubiKey OTP, or one-time password. So if you have YubiKey keys, and this is one of them right here, they come with this special, very interesting technology. Now, normally they use FIDO, which is supported in browsers and so on, but these keys have this special thing, and I'm gonna demonstrate this now, where they act like a keyboard, and every time you press the key, the key on the YubiKey, it will type a code, a one-time code on the keyboard. So let's take a look at this. So I'm gonna start by switching over to my desktop here. And before I go into MeshCentral and demoing this, I am just going to open a regular notepad, click the cursor on the inside the notepad here, and I'm going to go ahead and press the button on my YubiKey device. And when I press the button, it's going to basically send out this code here. Now, I'm using a developer key, so and the reason I mention that is because there's a unique identifier in this in addition to a one-time code. So anybody who has that, who has this code here, can see first your unique identifier for your key and then a hash that is one time. Okay. So MeshCentral supports this two-factor authentication key system, and the beauty of it is that you don't need any drivers. You don't need any support in the app, because all you need to do is click the cursor at the right place, tap the button, and the one-time code will show up. So by default, MeshCentral does not support this, and the reason is that you need to add some special instructions inside MeshCentral. So what you do is you go to the DuckDuckGo or whatever, and you type, you search for YubiKey OTP, enter, and the first link here will be YubiKey one-time password. You click on that, and here it will explain what this is, and it will tell you if you want to verify that a one-time password is correct, you have to basically sign up with their service. Now, the nice thing is it's totally free and you don't have to give them much information at all. It just tells you you'll need a API key, and the API key is available here. So you click here on the link, and all you need to do is type your email address, and then you tap the key just like I did before to get an API key. So you just type in your address, you press the button on your key to get this, you know, one-time code written in, you accept this, you say okay, and it will give you a API key. So I'll show you what this looks like. So this is the page we just looked at, where you enter your email address and you tap the button. Then the second thing, it will give you a client ID, which is a, you know, a 5 or 6 digit number, and then a secret key. And so you take these two things, and inside MeshCentral, you will go into the config.json, you will create a new section called YubiKey, and you will put the ID that they gave you, in my case, it's a 5-digit ID, and then the secret or the API key secret that they gave you. So you will need to do that inside your MeshCentral instance. Now, once you have that done, and I already have it done on my instance, so let's see, I'm gonna go over here and go back to my instance there. Okay, so once you have it done on your instance, when you click on my account, what I'm gonna do is delete this. I have a key here and it says OTP on it. I'm gonna remove this key. Okay, so now I'm not set up with two-factor authentication. I'm gonna go on manage security keys. And normally you would see add key here, which is for a FIDO key. So this is kind of, you know, all the other manufacturers, that's what they have. And it is actually a more robust security, and I'll come back to that. But if you've set up the API, the ID and the secret, you'll see the second button here for add YubiKey key. And you click on that, and it will ask you for a key name. You can leave it as default for my key. And then you click on the second one, the Yubikey OTP, and I'm just gonna go ahead and press that button. And now what's happening is that it got that one-time code, and MeshCentral went to the Yubikey servers and asked, is that code correct? And the server came back and said, yes, it is, and here's the unique identifier, and here's some information that will allow me, YubiKey to check again to make sure that it's the same key in the future. So I have it all set up now. I can hit close. Of course, when you set up two-factor authentication, you always want to set up two-factor authentication, always a backup. So here I'm gonna generate, you know, some keys, copy them. I'm gonna put them in Notepad right there, and I can use them as an alternative. So if ever my YubiKey is lost, I can use one of those backup codes as a one-time code. Okay, so now I can log out, and then I can log back in. Boom, boom. This is, of course, a developer machine, so I have a short password. And then it asks me for a token, and here I can use my one of the backup codes here. If I have the Google time-based one-time passwords from the Google Authenticator app or the Microsoft app or so on, you can use those 6 digits and type it here. But because I have a YubiKey OTP key set up, I'll just click the cursor right there, press the button on my key, and boom, I am logged in. Okay, so I got my two-factor authentication here. And one of the beautiful things about this is that not only do you not need any drivers, so you can basically bring this key onto any computer and plug it in, and it doesn't need to be recognized. Like your friend's computer doesn't need to know what a YubiKey or load any drivers, because it's just a keyboard. It acts like a keyboard. But the other nice thing about it is if you use a desktop app, for example, MeshCentral Router, I'm gonna try to log in here, and MeshCentral Router is asking me for a token. Now, MeshCentral Router does not support FIDO keys. So you can't, like, if you set up your FIDO key, it won't, you know, it won't work with MeshCentral Router, but the YubiKey OTPs do work. So I'm gonna select, you know, the token here, put the password the cursor the right place, hit the button, and boom, I'm logged in. So really super convenient. Now, I'm gonna tell you the one really big disadvantage of this type of two-factor authentication. It is not, it cannot guard against phishing attacks or man-in-the-middle attack. So if somebody goes onto a fake website, and a fake MeshCentral website, and then the fake MeshCentral website asks for the OTP token, and you tap that one-time token using your key, that one-time token can be used by the attacker to then turn around and go to the real website and log in as you. This is the same attack that can also happen with the Google Authenticator app or the Microsoft app whenever you have those 6 digits that are time-based and rotate. The problem with any of those is that if you go to the wrong website and type in your OTP key token, then the fake website can turn around and log into the real website and impersonate you. The reason why FIDO keys are defend against this is because when you tap the button on a FIDO key, the browser will take the name of the website, in this case central.mesh.meshcentral.com. It will take that name and will add it to the signature that the token generates, and then it will send that to the website. So if the real website sees a domain name that's incorrect, it will know that this is a token from an impersonator. So anyway, that's kind of a little detail there, but this is why FIDO keys are really the best two-factor authentication. But if you have thumbprints on phones or stuff like that, that's the best. But YubiKeys are great. They're cheap. You can get them online, and they don't require any drivers and stuff, and they work on desktop apps. So that's a demonstration of that. Hopefully that was useful. Thank you very much. Have a great day.